On to the other latest jibe that has come from Tamil Nadu, ladies and gentlemen. There is a Ram Rath that is backed by the VHP that is making its journey from Ayodhya to Rameshwaram and back over the last 46 days, over a 46-day period. The moment it has entered into Tamil Nadu, there have been multiple jibes that have been taken. The DMK has woken up, albeit a little late, especially Kanimori, objecting to the Ram Rajya Rath Yatra, accusing it of breaking the law. The Rajya Sabha MP, who took to social media to slam the Tamil Nadu government for providing security to the procession for breaking the law, she took the exception to the fact that the number plate of the vehicle was not visible owing to the fact that the Rath was also heavily decorated. Kanimori raising the Motor Vehicles Act and saying that this was after all just a motor vehicle. Ram Rath, what? It's a motor vehicle. So she has said. And this after M.K. Stalin and the others protested, created ruckus in the assembly, had a rasta roko. Now she has said the Ram Rajya Rath Yatra, the vehicle should be impounded under the Motor Vehicles Act, not given a free passage. This after the vehicle has come, gone through Tamil Nadu, into Rameshwaram, gone back, and now it's already exited into Kerala. That's the result. So let's open it up on the news hour tonight and saying, is this a Rath jibe to stem the saffron ride? What is the secret behind this Rath jibe? What is the allergy? Is the allergy to Ram and to Hindus, or is the allergy to BJP and the Saffron Brigade? Mr. Saravanan, please tell me, sir, because there are also unverified pictures doing the rounds,
yes,
of alleged DMK employees using slippers and slapping the face of Lord Ram's posters and pictures. These are also doing the rounds. So I'm going to ask you, I'm not putting those pictures because they are unverified. Anand has a Ram phobia.
Anand, I take strong exception to your statement that they are all from the DMK. They are not from the DMK.
I said it's so an allegation, sir. I'm not making the allegation. Please refute it is what I'm saying.
Fake statements. No. That's what you don't. Yeah. Don't even make those allegations, because in DMK, we don't stoop to such levels. We won't do that. And I want to make a difference here. BJP does not represent the Hindus or Hinduism. Hmm. BJP as a political ideology, a virulent form of Hindutva, which we do not subscribe to. We are Hindus, but we don't subscribe to Hindutva, to which the BJP subscribes.
Oh, that's a very
this
nuanced take that Mr. Saravanan
the
has
other
brought.
Aspect is this.
Go ahead, please. Complete.
Yes. And when we are speaking about this Ram Rajya Yatra, this Ram Rajya Yatra is opposed to the constitution. We have a Rajya which is based on the rule of law, on the constitution. We can't have any other Rajya which is opposed to the constitutional principles enshrined in our constitution. And we are a secular, socialist, democratic republic as per the preamble. So anything which tries to undermine this social fabric will be opposed by the DMK party, and it has no place in the state of Tamil Nadu, the place of the Periyar, the place of the rational movement, the place of the DMK. And that is why, on top of this, on top of all that, this has been made clear by our leader, Mr. M.K. Stalin. On the top of this, the Rath, which is doing the rounds here in Tamil Nadu, does not have or does not conform to the Motor Vehicles Act, and it cannot ply on the roads. When it is an illegality, it has to be stopped. It is very, very sad to see the police officers.
So you have no problem with Ram.
A violation,
you have no problem with Ram. You
have no problem with it.
You have no problem with Ram, despite what Mr. Karunanidhi had to say about the Ram Setu in the past. You don't have a problem with Ram.
We don't have problem with any religion, Anand,
okay,
provided they don't propagate caste hierarchy.
They don't
put some few castes on the pedestal and discriminate the others.
Let Mr. Narayan Tirupathi respond.
I'm very happy that Saravanan said that DMK will not stoop to that level, you know, by garlanding the Ram photos with slipper or slippering that photos. And he has accepted that EVR, that is EVRA, in their name it is Periyar. He has only slippered a Ram, and he has proved and he has accepted that EVRA had definitely stooped to the lowest level in the country by doing those acts. So will DMK condemn those acts? Will DMK regret for what EVR did to the Hinduism? And Saravanan has to answer for that. Number two is that, and today morning also I saw...
yes, I will answer that. I will answer
talking
that.
About, after that, no problem. See, I would like to ask Kanimuri or Saravanan that if you are saying that there is a violation of Motor Vehicle Act, just tell me why Kanimuri is going on a car which is violating the Motor Vehicle Act by having a party flag in it. Is it not a violation? And number three, Ram, you only DMK, DMK is more worried about the law, and they want to secure law, they want to keep the law definitely, you know, safely. First, let Saravanan or Kanimuri come and, Supreme Court and the High Courts have given judgments on cone speakers at religious places, especially mosques. First, ask Kanimuri and Saravanan, you please go to the Commissioner of Police and fight in the streets that the speakers from the mosque in Tamil Nadu should be removed, which is the judgment of the courts.
Saravanan, respond before I bring in Mr. Rajachekaran.
Really,
Saravanan, respond.
Party.
Yes, yes, yeah. Anand, when Mr. Narayanan and his the Prime Minister from the BJP, if he is going to apologize for what happened in Gujarat in 2002, then we can speak about what happened in 1967. Let him first apologize to the nation for what happened in 2002.
Saravanan,
then
sir,
we will bring
to that
about
level.
What happened in how innocent Muslims were killed under the watch. No. That's what I'm saying.
What about Godhra?
When innocent Muslims
Godhra,
were
what happened to Godhra?
In Gujarat.
You were part
under the watch,
of the, you were part
under the watch,
of the government
under the
in
watch,
NDA
under
that
the
time.
Watch of the present Prime Minister. So let us not forget all that, and let's come to a conclusion about
under
what happened
watch
in 2002.
Of your ministers,
then we can
in
go
Godhra,
to
Hindus
1950s and 1940s.
Burnt.
That's what
1950s and 1940s. You are pseudo secular. You are anti-Hindu.
Sir. Okay, 1 minute. Before you make the charge. Let me finish this. Okay.
Anand, let me finish this.
Okay, sir.
Let me finish this, Anand.
Okay, go ahead.
I am again telling you, reiterating, BJP is not the representatives of the Hindus or Hinduism. They practice a violent form of Hindutva which no self-respecting Hindu will follow.
DMK is not
answer,
a representative
that.
Of Tamilians. DMK is not representative of Dravidians.
Mr. Tirupati, sir, one of the allegations that are coming across is the BJP is targeting the democratic and secular culture of Tamil Nadu. It is in this context we wanted to expose their intentions behind the yatra. Second, they say that India is one country and has one culture. But in the Kaveri issue, they have deliberately stopped Tamil Nadu's rights. The center, particularly the Modi government, on the one hand, they deny the Tamil Nadu, the Tamil people, or deny Tamil Nadu its rights. And on the other hand, they want to bring their communal politics here. This is what Kaliappan, the state joint secretary of MKIK, has said. Now tell me.
See, as far as Kaveri issue is concerned, the central government has very clearly, you know, we have filed an affidavit in the court that the Kaveri Tribunal's judgment is the final, and the Supreme Court has got no authority. Now these people are saying that after the scheme, a name scheme has come, they say the tribunal's award is the final. That is what we have been saying. And when we have been saying for a very long time, more than 3-4 years, these people are shouting at us. Number two, who is secular? Now You said that, DMK employees did that. I am telling you, day for yesterday morning, when this Rajya Rath Yatra came, in near Pudukottai, one person called Sendil Kumar destroyed Eveyara statue. He belongs to DMK. He is a relative of DK Secretary Mr. Ravanan. And my party president, Dr. Tamilisai Soundararajan, has very clearly said that Mr. Stalin should regret for what he has commented. That BJP and the Hindutva, organizations are doing, have done this. No, this is being done wantedly. Eveyara statue has been demolished by DMK themselves, and they are trying to create a very big problem here. They are trying to create a tension here. We charge them directly. Sick. What is the answer?
Mr. Sendil Kumar,
he is
stop
a relative of DK.
Like the
he has worked for
does.
DMK.
Mr. We charge Tirupati, them. Stop peddling
this,
lies.
This is, the,
like
this
you
is what they
do.
Have been doing.
I have respect
communally,
for you. Don't
communally,
stop these
communally.
Lies.
No, no,
stop
I charge. No, no,
stop these
communally,
lies.
Communally,
stop
your
these
people
lies.
Have taken
stop
a procession
lies.
Yesterday. Today, the
lie,
entire Mayiladuthurai, Mayaram, Anand, you know
stop,
about Mayaram, the entire Mayiladuthurai, there was
lies.
A bond today.
Stop
no, no, it is not a lie. You
stop
prove that it
lies.
Is not that.
Stop these
Sendil
lies.
Kumar,
stop
Sendil
lies.
Kumar
stop
belongs
these
to DK.
Lies,
he has worked for DMK. We charge you prove it. I am charging, yes. You people wantedly. You are instigating people and
you
are trying to create attention.
This
it's
is getting fiery.
Communist Party of India, Francis.
This is getting fiery. And I'm enjoying this, but I have to be fair to Mr. Rajasekaran,
DMK's
who's been listening to you two
DMK's
gentlemen.
Anti-Hindu.
Now, Mr. Narayanan Tirupati and Mr. Saravanan, I'm bringing in Mr. Rajasekaran. Let me ask Mr. Rajasekaran this. Sir, in the Rath Yatra, on the 20th, it reached Rameshwaram. On 21st March, it reached Rameshwaram, it traversed to Tirunelveli, Tuticorin and Madurai districts. Now it has travelled back and it has already moved towards Kerala because the Andhra Pradesh High Court said you are not coming into Andhra Pradesh or Telangana. Let me ask you this, Mr. Rajasekaran. Why did Ms. Kannimodi wake up only today? If they wanted to block it, if they thought it's a Motor Vehicles Act violation, they should have told the government to do it and seize the vehicle the moment it entered Tamil Nadu.
Anand, see, the Indian Constitution gives the right for all the religions to propagate, spread and preach about their religion. Going by that merit and point, be it Hindu, Muslim, Christian, any yatra, any procession, any preaching should be allowed legitimately with due permission from the concerned authorities, be it state government police or whichever authority, local body authority. In this case, see, the permission was granted, I was told, but there is a violation with regard to Motor Vehicles Act, Tamil Nadu Motor Vehicles Act 1988, because when you make any modification, the RTO concerned has to certify it, saying this, these deviations have been taken
sir.
Place. And the please allow me.
Oh,
see, I am not questioning
so,
the.
So you
yatra.
Have a Motor Vehicles Act violation.
No
you will
I,
think
no,
about
no.
For a Ram Rath. Half
no,
the,
no,
half
no
the vehicles run by the politicians in Tamil Nadu
have
dark tinted glasses. They've got stickers and wrong format number plates with their names and their party names there. They have party flags on all of that.
Yes.
So all of that is not Motor Vehicles Act violation.
Yes,
not at all.
It is violation. No,
that,
no.
That is not Motor Vehicles violation.
No,
those
Anand,
vehicles should not be seized.
No, I'll tell you. Please
but,
allow me.
But
when you ask
a Ram Rath Yatra which is making a trip, that is a Motor Vehicles violation.
No, see, there
that
was,
the
I expect, no, Anand, I expect the same concern when the churches are being attacked at Madurai, the Nagarkoil and other areas.
Of course,
you
sir.
Should debate on that.
Of
when
course.
When a mosque is attacked.
Of
so
course.
All this
those churches
of
course.
Debated.
But I'll tell you what. I'll tell you what.
No,
one second. One second. Mr. Rajasekaran, let me ask you this. Why is it, sir? Why is it? Why is it? Why is it that whenever we ask, whenever I ask a question about a regarding Ram or a Hindu issue, why is it that you always talk about what is happening with churches and what is happening with mosques and what
no,
is happening
Anand,
with I am asking you this.
No, even that,
if
no,
anything happens with any particular illegal religious belief, faith or institution, we will question it and we will debate
yes.
it. We have to be
Anand,
impartial.
Anand,
but why are you bringing
Anand,
in a church issue when I am talking about a Ram Rath? Why
no,
do you have
I
to do
no,
that?
No, I
why only
no
when you
problem.
Talk about some other religion, when I am talking about Hinduism, that's when you will come across as secular, is it?
No. Please,
no, is that the case?
You have misunderstood my point.
No, no, are you trying to say that I am secular
point.
Because I talk about churches also? Sir, please, let's not
no.
play that game.
No, I am not making any wild allegation, neither I am playing to the galleries as you are pointing out. I am only saying I have no problem in Ram Raj Yatra because if they had got permission, they are absolutely on the right track to go. They have no, nothing against the law.
Hmm.
But when there is a problem, it has to be addressed, it has to be debated, it has to be questioned. It applies to all religions.
Sir, the
not
questioning has to be,
Yatra, any
no, the questioning has
Hindu,
to be,
Muslim, Christian,
when
Parsi,
you have
anything.
The presence of VHP elements with the Yatra. When you have the element, when you have the presence of certain quasi-political outfits backing this Rath Yatra and the agenda that they are wanting to push, you question that. But don't come and abuse Ram and don't try and come and try and hurt the sentiments of Hindus. I'm
no,
just saying on both
not.
Sides you are playing with
definitely
sentiment. Mr.
Not.
Narayan Tirupati, am I fair
definitely
in saying
not.
That if there
not
are, you can
Ram
have
Raj
an
Yatra.
Issue with VHP, you can have an issue with the elements who you believe are rabble-rousers. You can have an issue with Bajrang Dal saying that they are violent. But you cannot say that you paint the Rath Yatra and paint Ram in bad light. Abuse Ram because you have a problem with VHP. That's not fair. Mr. Narayan Tirupati. Why was the VHP overtly,
yeah.
covertly
see,
trying to enter
see.
And traverse Tamil Nadu in the guise of
what
a Ram Rath Yatra?
No, see, that is not, see, this Ram Rath Yatra, it is organized every year. They are touring throughout India. This year they have covered 6 states. They have taken permission in November itself. This is not even by VHP. This is by a separate organization. They are doing it. And they have taken permission. See, even as per Motor Vehicle Act, why these restrictions are there? If somebody, some vehicle without number plate or something, you know, they hit and run, then it will be easy for people to chase. That is the reason. This is going with the police. This is going with security. Nothing is going to happen. So we have to take everything into account. If they are these people, DMK is concerned about more about the law and the, you know, justice, they should definitely tomorrow morning Kanimuri should go on to Twitter and say that as per Supreme Court and High Court judgments, the religious places should remove the cone speakers in Tamil Nadu. Will she do it? Will
Sir,
DMK do it?
No. Will you also say that you remove cone speakers across all religious outfits? So that includes the
yes.
temples also.
Temples,
that includes the
mosque.
Temples also.
Yes.
That
temples,
includes the temples
mosque.
Also,
yes.
sir. Conical yes. speakers should be done across
yes,
Tamil Nadu, not just
yes.
Tamil Nadu, across the country, whichever religious
yes.
outfit. Not just conical
yes.
speakers. Everything
yes,
that
yes,
is creating
Anand.
Noise pollution
yes,
in the guise
Anand.
Of
yes.
faith.
Yes. I definitely say.
Sarvanand, last word. Sarvanand, last 30
seconds. Be removed from all temples.
So move a petition, sir. Move a petition
yeah.
in the
yeah.
Madras
see,
High Court.
Anand,
ask
Anand,
EPS, OPS
yeah,
to
yeah,
do something
Anand,
about it.
Anand, yeah,
yes.
yeah. Anand,
yes, Sarvanand. 30 seconds.
Anand, I have a question.
Yes.
Anand, I have a question here.
Yes.
See, our party, the DMK party, did bring in a legislation which says anybody from any caste can become a priest in the temple. Will Mr. Narayanan Tirupati agree to that? Will he fight for that in the Supreme Court? Will he say yes,
yes
and implement it across
yes.
the country because
yes.
he is concerned about the Hindus?
So
yes. I am asking
so,
him,
so from
will he answer
Ram
that?
So from Ram
yes
Rath
to it?
Caste politics,
Anand.
It swings all
Anand.
Across in Tamil Nadu. These are
wherever
interesting days
BJP
in the state.
Is in rule,
it's not about caste politics. It is
caste.
About removing
exactly,
caste
sir.
System
exactly.
from Hinduism.
Only
exactly.
Tamil Nadu.
Exactly.
You are not
let's start
all
respecting
caste.
All faith. Let us not try and marginalize and have an issue with a Rath that is peacefully making its way and try and exact political poundage out of that. That's all is my submission. Saravanan, Rajasekaran, Narayanan Tirupati, thank you very much for joining me on the News RFN. Thank you, sir.